Now, I have to team up with doctors and patients from around the country to stop the twindemic. Sounds like a superhero movie, doesn't it? It's like a plot. Well, getting the flu shot this year is a heroic move. So it would fit the plot. Flu season on top of COVID will only make things more complicated. Dr. Jennifer Caudill joins us from New Jersey. Dr. Caudill, there's new guidance on when people should be getting their flu shots this year. What is it?
That's right. So we definitely don't want people getting their flu shots too early, which is really by definition July or August. So this is the time to get it right now. Ideally, we want to get that flu shot before the end of October. That's going to be really important because we know it takes 2 weeks for that flu shot to build up protection in your body. So now is the time to go out and get that shot.
All right. Now is the time. Let's go to Dr. Alex Kessler, a pediatrician live from Orlando, Florida. So what do you say to parents who, because of COVID, are scared to bring their kids to the doctor right now for a flu shot?
It makes sense that people are concerned about coming into a healthcare environment, but we're all taking every precaution that we possibly can to keep our spaces safe, to keep our patients protected from COVID, and we protect one another as staff as well so that we don't share the disease. And giving up protection against diseases that we know can also hurt us is a big mistake. So it's really important, not only for your flu shots, but for every childhood vaccine, that you come into your physician's office and get vaccinated.
All right, again, if it's the best thing for you and your family, don't let anything get in the way. There was a study of nearly 12,000 Americans that found that those who had the flu shot last year were less likely to test positive for COVID-19. So I'm going to be getting clear about this. The flu vaccine only protects against the flu, not coronavirus, but there's lots of things going on here. And getting the flu shot does reduce the chances of having both viruses simultaneously and all the confusion that would develop because the symptoms overlap. With that in mind, this is why I have my mask on, because all these doctors, including me, will be giving flu shots to their patients at the same time as I give one to one of my best producers, Jillian, who is here getting her first flu shot in years. Well, first of all, thank you for trusting me. But if you could explain to everybody at home, why is it that you have been reluctant to get a flu shot?
I haven't had one since I was a kid. And I know it's bad to say that as a producer here, but I just didn't trust that it was needed, you know, that it would protect me against the flu if I got it. And I haven't had the flu, so I just didn't feel the need for it.
But you did have something else this spring.
I did. So this is why I'm sitting in this chair, like heart pounding, because I had COVID in the spring and it was not a fun experience. I do not wish that on anyone. And I cannot imagine having COVID and the flu. I do not want them at the same time, a week apart, a month apart. I don't want them at all. So if I can mitigate those risks.
Well, we're going to do that today.
Okay.
Thank you for trusting me. All right. Now we'll take a deep breath. Then we're all going to do this together. Is everyone ready? Hey, look forward. Now, my dad taught me how to give shots. So this is a proven technique. So I pardon for pinching you, but it distracts you. Everyone ready? Yep. Set. Vaccinate. That's it. And you're done. Then we're done.
That's it?
You're done.
Okay.
Now, I want an honest opinion. Oh, I don't even need a Band-Aid. There's nothing going on here. Did it really hurt? Jillian.
I mean, it was a little sting.
Oh, come on, Jillian.
It was bearable.
I can't even find this site. Can we get a close-up here? Because I can't even see where I injected. I mean, it's sort of difficult. I think there might be some... Well, not really. You know what? Let me just focus. We need a microscope to find the spot.
But I do want a Band-Aid.
You'll get a Band-Aid. Okay. Of course you'll get a Band-Aid. Jesse, you just got your shot from Dr. Tess Palacios. How did it go? Did
just
it hurt?
Just a pinch.
Just a pinch? Was it worth it?
Yes, absolutely.
Listen, for all the doctors who are here today, thank you very much for keeping our communities healthy. And to everyone else, you have the power to keep our country and your loved ones safe. So do your part. Get a flu vaccine. Jillian, high-five him. Okay. Boom! I'm always proud of you, but even more today than usual. God bless you. We'll be right back.